And as NATO decides on its exit strategy, Australian Army officers in Afghanistan say they do not yet trust the soldiers they're trying to train up. 10's Hugh Wimmington reports it's a problem that could delay our departure from the war zone.
A seasoned Afghan field commander has told 10 News that Australia and the coalition forces can leave Afghanistan within a year with mission accomplished. But there is a catch.
Major Azbuddin Handarabi has been a soldier here for 23 years. He loves the Aussies, he says, but what he really wants is our gear. Give us your armoured vehicles, your helicopters and electronics, he tells me, and we will beat the Taliban ourselves. You'll be gone in a year. It won't happen. Australia is upbeat about progress.
I've seen an exponential improvement in the situation here. I mean, I'm not saying it's easy, and I'm not saying the job's done. It's far from done.
But we won't be handing over our high-tech warfighting equipment, partly because a largely illiterate army couldn't keep it running, and partly because we don't trust them. When we share the danger of joint patrols, the Afghan troops only learn what they're doing or where they're heading as they step out to prevent them tipping off the insurgents. We don't let them near our life-saving bomb-beating electronics gear for fear the Taliban will get that too. To give you some idea, fully one-third of the original recruits to this Afghan battalion had to be kicked out because they were found to have active links to the Taliban. Major Handarabi says questions about the loyalty of his men make him angry. In his assessment, the Taliban and Al-Qaeda will definitely be back if the coalition leaves too soon, with bitter consequences for the world. We need you with us for a long time, he says. How long is up to God? In Afghanistan, Hugh Rimmington, 10 News.